ఏపీ స్టేట్ సిపిఐ సోషల్ మీడియా విభాగం సామాజిక మాధ్యమాల ప్రేక్షకులకు స్వాగతం, సుస్వాగతం. కామ్రేడ్ వినయ్ విశ్వంతో ఇప్పుడు ముఖాముఖి కార్యక్రమం. కామ్రేడ్ వినయ్ విశ్వం సిపిఐ పార్టీ జాతీయ కార్యదర్శి, రాజ్యసభ సభ్యులు కూడా. వినయ్ విశ్వం గారితో ఇంగ్లీష్లో మాటామంతి కార్యక్రమం ఉంటుంది. డియర్ కామ్రేడ్ వినయ్ విశ్వంజీ, ఐఎమ్ షఫీ అహ్మద్. ఐఎమ్ రిప్రజెంటింగ్ టు ఏపీ స్టేట్ సిపిఐ సోషల్ మీడియా. సార్, వెరీ సింపుల్ విశ్వంజీ, వీ కేమ్ టు నో దట్ యు ఆర్ కమింగ్ ఫ్రమ్ సమ్వేర్ టు అనంతపురం టు అటెండ్ ఇన్ ఏఎస్ఎఫ్ నేషనల్ కాన్ఫరెన్స్. హౌ యూ ఫీల్ అబౌట్ ది నేషనల్ కాన్ఫరెన్స్? What you are going to do the youth and the student, is it good way to promote them, to agitate them in struggling the activities, revolutionary activities?
No doubts, they are the future. The students and the youth of today, they are the comrades and they are the cadets and are the fighters to build a new India in the coming days. So with all earnestness, we should support them, we should promote them, we should understand their concerns in a proper way, and in such a way they will be much useful for the revolutionary movement in the future. With that perspective in mind, we have to approach the student movement and youth movement. I was there in Anandapur, and what I could witness there is very inspiring, that from more than 22 states, delegates came for the ASF 29th National Conference. Representing 22 states is not a small thing. That means AISF has its presence at various levels in almost all nook and corner of this vast country. Representing these 22 states, about 1,000 delegates have assembled in Anandapur. Marking the opening of the AISF conference, there was a mammoth student rally in which boys and girls of the AISF took part with all vigor, shouting slogans and telling the country that they are ready for a fight to defend secularism, to uphold socialism, and to fight the fascist menace that is trying to undermine the basic interests of the people of this country. The fascist Modi government, when it tried to do away with all the values of the Indian education system and to twist the educational agenda in favor of rightist fascist offensive, being a part of that, when universities are attacked, when textbooks are rewritten, when student cadets are haunted, when the schools and colleges and all the system of education is facing great challenges, this AISF National Conference has great significance, and I am sure that our young comrades of the AISF, we feel proud that many of us are the products of the AISF. We came to the movement through the AISF. We understood India through the AISF. So when AISF is growing, we are all naturally proud of that. With that emotional fervor also, we feel that AISF National Conference in Anandapur will be remembered as a great landmark in the onward march of this great organization called All India Students Federation.
Thank you, Viswamji. You know very well about the Modi government is destroyed the social life of country people and secular system, democratic values. How we people like we people, we prevent this dangerous situation?
No doubt, Narendra Modi government, which is controlled by the RSS, is trying to unleash an attack on all those great values that India cherishes so close to her heart. That government is against secularism. This government is against sovereignty of the country. Modi government is anti-democratic. They are not for democracy of India. And they dislike even the word of socialism. All these are the basic features of the constitution in which the preamble underlines. The preamble of the constitution itself says that we, the people of India, having solemnly resolved to constitute India into a sovereign, democratic, secular, socialist republic. It is for that goal the country has made a constitution. And Modi government stands against all these goals. Openly, they want to rewrite the constitution, dismantle the constitution, attack all those values of the constitution. And many of them, like their ministers, leaders and MPs, have openly said that they are for changing the constitution. And some enthusiasts among them have even went to the extent of saying that when we rewrite the Indian constitution, it should be on the lines of Manusmriti. That means, according to them, India should be taken back to centuries back, where superstitions, all sort of inhuman activities were the rule of the day. They want an India of those dark days. So they should be fought out with all possible might. And as a cadre of the Communist Party of India, I am quite sure that CPI is the first party to understand the significance of this fight and categorically state that the Modi government is a fascist government. When many people, even among the left, were having a confusion that whether in India to categorically state that the present government is a fascist government, even while many among the left were having a confusion whether to call it a fascist government or not, without any inhibition, CPI came forth to state that this government is outrightly a fascist government. Ideologically, because of its social views, due to its economic agenda, this government is a fascist government. It is preaching the basic doctrines of fascism. And that basic doctrines are, one is racial supremacy. That's a Brahmanistic Hindutva ideology. Then it's subservience to the interests of the finance capital. When finance capital and racial supremacy hold their hands together, when these two elements come together, the history tells us that fascism will emerge. Fascism is the outcome of the wedding between this ideology of racial supremacy and the economics of finance capital. That exactly is what is happening in India. Modi government is paving the way for that. So this government is a fascist government, and that fascist government, according to CPI's understanding, is the main enemy of Indian people today. For a communist party, that's a very important point. A question will come before all the communists in every country. in certain part of the history, and that question is exactly this: which is your main enemy?
Vishwamji, now you are telling about historical facts. Something we are having ancient secular history in this country. We are ideal for globe also. Why our Indian people allowing these saffronic forces to sabotage the secular system of this country?
No, the people of India are not allowing it. They will not allow. But people like you and me, the communists, our duty is to teach the people, tell the people, to impress the people about the danger of fascism. We have to learn what fascism is. We should learn from history that how fascism emerged in various countries, including Italy and Germany. If you read that history in the proper sense, one should be clear that in the same lines through which Hitler and Mussolini came to power, Modi also is trying to come to power. So, these historical teachings are very important today. Ideologically, historically, and politically, the masses should be enlightened to open their eyes towards the danger of fascism, which is looming over the future of Indian history. That's the task of the left. So, to fulfill that task, left should understand clearly who your main enemy is. And when you come to understand that the main enemy is fascism, then comes the question: to fight the main enemy, who your allies are? So Communist Party of India have tried to answer both these questions. Our main enemy is fascist forces represented by Narendra Modi government and controlled by the RSS with its very dangerous ideology and economics. To fight this RSS, let me conclude. And to fight this fascist danger, which is the main enemy, our allies are all secular, democratic and progressive forces. With this idea in mind, the Communist Party has put forth a very correct slogan of forging a broad platform of forces to fight the fascist danger. And that forces includes all those parties, forces, individuals, organizations who are committed to secularism, democracy and left ideology. They all should come together. It may not be a permanent alliance forever. It cannot be even called as a united front with political terms all over the country. Its composition, the tune of the fight, the nature of the fight may be differ from state to state according to the conditions, but that fight is the most important fight, and the Communist Party is preparing itself, arming itself to undertake this fight.
Vishwamji, there is a very clear issue. The saffronic forces forcibly killing the Dalits and minorities in the name of cow and cow slaughter. How can our people, it means communist peoples, red shirt volunteers, they taking against, rapid against this saffronic forces?
No, physically and ideologically and politically, they attack the people. All the downtrodden are under attack. Maybe Dalits, maybe workers, maybe the minorities, maybe the women, all who are oppressed are under constant attack from the forces of RSS Sangh Parivar, which we call saffronic forces. We attack them not because of a color. We attack them because of their ideology, which is 100% rightist ideology, anti-people ideology. And in that fight, the left, the communists particularly, should tell the people and convince the people that we are their comrades in arms in this fight against fascism. Only in that way, we can inculcate a sort of confidence among the people that they can be fought out and we will fight them. Yesterday came the Supreme Court verdict on the Bhima Karegaon incidents. I should say that in the course of the case, Maharashtra police run by the BJP government, they came out with a fantastic story that these five people, the human rights activists, they were trying to kill none other than Narendra Modi. Very funny stories they are cooking up. Cooking up of stories is a basic nature of the fascist ideology. They cooked up a story in the history. When Hitler was trying to become powerful by all means in Germany, he also cooked up a story. His story was that the communists are trying to undermine democracy in Germany and Hitler managed a stage play. He got a very nonsense person whose name was Van der Loop. And making use of Van der Loop, he put the German parliament Reichstag to fire. When Reichstag was put on fire, Hitler and his cronies began to cry out, "Look, communists has put the parliament under fire. It is they who put the fire on the parliament. They want to do away with the democracy. So, isolate the communists." This was the slogan. In that case, they involved all the communist leaders, including great Georgi Dimitrov, as plotters against parliament and parliamentary system. History can never forget that happenings in the German Court of Justice. In that court, Georgi Dimitrov, the great communist, he exposed the drama behind this arsonage, behind this fire. He tiles Goebbels and Göring in the right and left hands of Hitler and he exposed them and he proved that it is not the communists but this henchmen of the Hitler cronies, they put fire on the German parliament. In the same way, they are trying to cooking up stories in India also. This story of attempt to kill Narendra Modi is nothing but remind us that incident of history. That is why I tell you, learning history is an important thing in this great battle against fascism.
Thank you.
Let us conclude here because I have to go for the meeting.
Okay. Thank you, sir. Samji. Ippudu varaku Vinay Viswam garito mukhamukhi karyakramanni memu vinnaru. Ee deshamlo secular fascist shaktula madhya పోరాటం ప్రారంభమైందని, సెక్యులర్ శక్తులు ప్రజాస్వామ్య శక్తులు సంఘటితంగా కావాల్సిన అవసరం ఉందని, అందుకు కమ్యూనిస్టు పార్టీ ఆఫ్ ఇండియా కీలకమైన పాత్ర పోషిస్తుందని చెప్పి చెప్పారు. రానున్న ఎన్నికల్లో ఫాసిస్టు శక్తులను ఓడించేందుకు పూర్తి స్థాయిలో కమ్యూనిస్టు వామపక్ష సెక్యులర్ శక్తులు ఉద్యమించాలని చెప్పి వినయ్ విశ్వం ఈ సందర్భంగా పిలిపించారు. కామ్రేడ్ వినయ్ విశ్వంకు ధన్యవాదాలు.
సలాం. ఓకే.